Australia has launched a world-first mental health and wellbeing strategy for children. The framework will provide a guide to help maintain and support the mental health and wellbeing of children below the age of 12, as well as their families as well. Well, joining me live now is Christine Morgan. She's the CEO of the National Mental Health Commission. Joins me out of Canberra. Christine, good to see you. Thanks for your time this morning. So, first of all, I mean, just to explain this simply, this help that's available for kids under the age of 12, what does it do and how do you get the help?
Okay, so it's really about setting the strategic framework, Pete. It's about saying we've never, ever, ever had a strategy as to how to address mental health and wellbeing for our littlies. Traditionally, it started from about 14 years and upwards. So this is really saying, firstly, let's change the language away from a medical diagnosis and talk about their mental health and wellbeing. Let's look at them in the setting of family and communities, education, as well as health. And let's make sure we intervene early. We try and prevent and we try and enforce it. Then you get to your service levels, of course, we need to do that. But predominantly it's about focusing in on the mental health and wellbeing of our little ones.
How does someone under the age of 12 know that they need professional help?
What a great question, Pete. And I think one of the key planks of the strategy is how can we help parents understand when we need to intervene? The first thing we've really done is to move away from language that talks about a medical diagnosis. And we talk about how children are functioning. So when they're well, when they're coping, when perhaps they're struggling, and when they're unwell. And that can really help parents say, oh, I can now actually look at my little person in terms of how they're behaving and interacting, and maybe I do need to do something.
Yeah. I mean, are there certain triggers that one should look out for?
Look, I think I always say parents know their kids best. You yeah. know when something is just a bit out of kilter. So I think trust those instincts. If your child seems to be really struggling, anxious, and always remembering something like a tummy ache can actually be the result of anxiety. So I think it's stopping, listening, interacting with a young person, and if you're thinking something's not right, intervening and doing something.
And what are the differences that apply to the treatment of mental health, the differences between applying that to adults and then to children? What are the differences between that?
Well, look, in a sense, it's really kind of a spectrum, but I think with young people and children in particular, often it will come out more in their behaviours. So we know for mental health generally that it is a translation of our behaviour and our feelings. As adults, we try to find the language to put that into words, and that can help then in identifying whether it's a mental illness that needs to be diagnosed or how else we manage it. Mm. With children, it is much more about observing how they're interacting with others, how they're behaving, and as I say, we really want them to thrive within their families and their communities.
And how much of an effect has the... I mean, we've spoken to this a few times about this in the past 18 months or so. How much of it has been exacerbated by the pandemic?
Look, I'm certainly worried about it, Pete, to be honest. I mean, particularly if I go back to my old stamping ground of eating disorders, we have seen just an escalation in what we call early onset eating disorders, which is pre-puberty, so 8, 9, 10-year-olds. We're seeing ongoing psychological distress and anxiety for our young people. So I don't think we can say that happens just in adolescence. I do think we need to be particularly alert to our children and intervene. We can change things for them. I think that's the key thing, that if we do intervene early, we can turn things around and find those ways to best support them.